So, I mean, the reason I wrote that was obviously because I had moved around a lot up till then and lived in like 12 different places. But no one really wanted to sign the song or my music. And if they did, they wanted me to change it. So my manager and I then decided to start our own label. And we kind of developed a strategy of how we'd put it out there, like without using, like as a big major label would do, like a lot of money, and because we didn't have actually any money. So we basically invested all of what we had into this label, into the first release of No Roots. And yeah, and with the strategy that we used, we kind of like built it up on the blog side. So we kind of, we had a guy who did online promotion for us. And that kind of started growing then in different blogs, and they went like number one in Hype Machine, and it kind of just grew organically from there. It was just really interesting to see, it was like a snowball coming down a mountain, just seeing quickly how big it was getting. I wouldn't be doing this if other people were telling me what my music should sound like, because it's, I feel like I'd be cheating on myself. We'd both studied together. So I studied songwriting, and he studied music business. And we both had kind of like, he had a few subjects with music and I had a few subjects with business. And we'd been already working together in our very first semester, but just kind of as like friends. So I would have gigs where it was just me and my guitar in like a mall. And when he was 16 years old, he started his own technical company. So he would buy lots of like technical like things for musicians, like amps and microphones. And he would rent that out to other bands. And I didn't have any of that. So he kind of like just gave it to me for free and did my sound and everything. Cause I had no idea about like sound. All I did was play guitar and write songs. And so we kind of completed each other in that sense. And we lived also in the same housing. So he was like my next door neighbor. And yeah, we just kind of, it grew from there. Like we developed a strategy through different people we'd met in the industry. I had been working with different producers. Like when I wasn't studying, I was every weekend in Berlin meeting different producers, seeing what kind of like music I like and what kind of sound I want to create. I definitely feel the more I'm on tour, the more, like I'm always surrounded by people, like 24/7. And the moment I'm not surrounded by someone, it feels very strange. Like it feels like I'm, like a part of me is missing. It's kind of scary sometimes. Like it really is very, very strange. But I think it's important to still have those moments where you can be alone. And that's also a lot of the times, those are the moments where I kind of realize or come up with like song ideas and just words or sentences that I've been collecting. Like the next single we're putting out, that's a word I've been having in my head for the last 2 years. And yeah, so that's, I guess, how I also collect inspiration. I mean, I have to admit, I used to hate it. I used to hate moving from place to place. I was always so mad at my parents. Like when I found out we're moving to Germany when I was 13, I was devastated. I cried like every night for like a month. Cause I'm someone who likes to have a base. I like to have like certain friends in a city and do like stuff with them on the weekends. But then I realized through all the moving, I became very restless, just like my parents, I think. And yeah, I think it definitely helped me for this lifestyle now. If I had stayed in one place, I would be homesick probably 50% of the tour, and I'm never homesick. I miss like my parents sometimes or whatever, but I'm never like, oh, I really miss that one place. Like it's, yeah, it's weird. How did that come about? Well, his management reached out to my label in America, because we signed with an indie label called Mom and Pop. And they reached out to them and also to my manager, Paul. And they were like, hey, we'd love to have her on tour. Originally it was supposed to be for like 2 months. And we're like, really sorry, but we have like shows in Europe that we want to do and we can't go on tour for 2 months and just like, just for the US. Cause we had already like confirmed other shows. So, yeah, they then came back and they're like, hey, how about you do like a month and a half? And we're like, okay, we'll do a month and a half. And we can combine it with like a few other festivals that we're doing in America, so. That was crazy. That was an experience I will never forget. I think that was probably one of the moments where I finally kind of realized what's been going on, and I finally felt proud of myself and was like, hey, this is kind of cool that you get to play here tonight. And I just tried to enjoy it as much as I can, because, I mean, it's one of those experiences that are like one in a lifetime, I find. And I was just really happy and proud. Baking. I love baking. And what else? I like swimming. I like swimming and baking.
What's your favorite thing to bake?
Brownies. I love baking. No, I really like, there's a lemon dessert that I really like making. It has like a crumble base and a really nice soft lemon kind of thing on. It's like a lemon custard on top. It's really yummy. I love making marble cake. I'm really good at making apple crumbles. Anything with apples. I love apple pancakes. So good. Just like putting a piece of apple in the pancake with a little bit of cinnamon and brown sugar. Future ambitions. If I'm completely honest, I don't think I would have like a one, I don't have one ambition where I'm like, okay, this is what I want to achieve. I just want to continue touring. I want to continue making music that I like and that other people might like. But it's also the messages in the songs that are really important to me. I feel like there's a lot of things I need to get off my chest and what I want to like share with people. Because I feel like a lot of other people might feel the same way. And even if like I'm never like hugely successful, I think it'd be cool to just keep on doing what we're doing now and just, yeah, enjoy it, definitely.